Now, KSBW Weather Plus with Jim VanderZwan.
Along the coast, it's a whole different looking day than it was just a couple of days ago. Fog and low clouds moving back in there just before the sun angle gets too low. On the visible satellites, you can see it's just punching into the Salinas Valley. So we're back to something rather typical here, and that's, of course, part of the natural air conditioning. Before it got there, it was still in the 80s up in the Santa Cruz Mountains, 79 in Santa Cruz, said Ron, 73 in Watsonville. And around the peninsula, cooling off a little bit as that cool air came in there, 61 in Marina, 63 in Pacific Grove and Carmel by the Sea, but 67 in Monterey, had a little more sun going there. 78 Big Sur, 74 in Carmel Valley. Salinas checking in with a nice 76. 80s for the rest of the valley. So that's quite a drop from those triple-digit numbers we started the week with. And we only got up to about 91 as a hot spot. That in Morgan Hill, 90 in Gilroy, and even that's cooling down a little bit, 88 in Hollister. Meanwhile, to the south, we're seeing some thunderstorms have for the last day or so. Whole bunch of lightning strikes, a lot of heavy rain even impacting the Padres game down there in San Diego. Scattered storms moving up the Sierra Nevada. And the counterclockwise rotation may take some of this, well, later tonight into the mountains of San Benito County and South Monterey County. So if you see the flash of lightning in the dark of night and you hear the rumble of thunder, that'll be the source. Not so much rain, but boy, hopefully it doesn't start any fires. 90s and 100s for highs today out in the Central Valley. 71 in San Francisco, 81 in L.A., and 101 again in Palm Springs. So it's pretty warm in Southern California. Likewise in Phoenix, 92 in Boise with a 71 in Seattle. 73 in Bismarck, nice 79 in St. Louis, then 86 in New Orleans, and 78 in New York. But that's deceiving because it wasn't a pleasant day on the East Coast at all. A lot of subtropical moisture from the Carolinas all the way on up into parts of New England and Maine. And rainfall amounts from a few inches to upwards of 8 inches. Tons of flooding, lots of delays, flights backed up. It is an absolute mess and a good bunch of wind with it, too. Tomorrow that pushes up toward New England into the Canadian Maritimes. Got an upper level trough on this end of the map for a pleasant fall weather to the south, but still very wet on that end of the line. High pressure ridge here, that weak upper level low will spin around for another day before a trough moves into the north, and it will scoot those high clouds out. But right now on the water vapor satellite, you can see the counterclockwise rotation. So tomorrow we could stand to get some high clouds out of that. And in the valleys where it's still warm, it might even feel a tad muggy as a result. But I doubt that we'll see any rain out of it. If anything, a lightning bolt is the only thing we're concerned about. This trough is going to push into the north, and that's what's going to flatten out our high-pressure ridge. For now, nothing on the rain models, but we likely will see some high clouds with that little circulation, and then it gets bumped inland. Low-level flow back to onshore here. We can see that there. You look at this, well, by 6 o'clock, we're moving into that, and then we're going to fill the overnight valleys, overnight, I should say. Marine layer at about 1,000 feet, so it's pretty close to the ground, but it might lift a little bit overnight to about 1,200, 1,500 feet. Back off in the morning, still some gray around the bay, then clear off, probably lingers around Pacific Grove, likely to be later in the afternoon before it finally slides back in. And if we can keep that plan going for the weekend, we're in good shape for the air show, because all we need is some good flying weather between about 11 and 4. That's when everybody's in the air. 60s, 70s. We'll do it for the Bay Area. Looking good there. Some 80s in Morgan Hill, Gilroy, Hollister. But comfortable numbers compared to what we had earlier this week, of course. 73 in Salinas. We'll figure on an 86 in King City. Carmel Valley, rather. 76 as well, but a little bit cooler by about 10 degrees around the peninsula with some fog lingering around the peninsula, but some areas clear up pretty good. A little more sun, a little sooner. 74 Santa Cruz and Capitola, 73 Watsonville, and some 80s for the mountains. So mostly clear in the valleys, but the local dense fog near the bay and the north end of the Salinas Valley already pushes a little farther inland, then backs off. Partly cloudy with those high clouds, and the morning low clouds will get you to mostly sunny on Saturday. And as we go flying, here you go. Salinas Airport, that's where it's all happening Saturday and Sunday. Tomorrow there'll be a practice show. You'll hear the Thunderbirds. They're already in town. Morning clouds, then mostly sunny and 70s for highs and a little breeze in the afternoon, and that's just about right. 70s and 80s, a little bit cooler by a couple of degrees, along with more sunshine, but a little bit of night and morning fog, low clouds in the valleys and along the coast. 60s and 70s will do it. And we'll still likely clear off. We typically do this time of year, so if we can get that burned out by about 10, 11 o'clock, we're in good shape. Then offshore flow likely back Tuesday and Wednesday, but this time around, she won't be packing any heat. Just nice and warm little weather for the locals. Nothing like hundreds again.
We'll take that.
Yeah, that's
good
about
stuff.
Right.
Okay.